Jim Colt here from Hypertherm. I wanted to broach on a subject that comes up just about every day on online forums or somebody on the phone or an email to me. Customers asking about which process is best for them. You know, there's a lot of different ways to cut metals, plasma, water jet, laser, and oxy fuel, and a few others. You can use saws and you know, others, but those are the main ones, plasma, water jet, laser, and oxy fuel, that are used on CNC cutting tables like the one behind me here. Well, in reality, there's no one process that's going to be perfect for every application. So if you can provide details about the type of application you want, what's most important to you? Is it perfect cut quality? You're not going to get that with any of them. Nothing's perfect. Is it speed? You just need the biggest pile of parts off the table at the end of the day. You've got it, or do you have to cut some 3-inch thick mild steel today and some 26 gauge steel tomorrow, or do you cut metal 80% of the time, but every once in a while need to throw a piece of wood or a piece of glass up on the table? Because not all these processes cut, you know, all materials like that. I guess in a nutshell, let me just talk about plasma versus water jet versus laser versus oxy fuel. And I've been in a number of facilities that have every one of those processes on their shop floor, and they use them for what they're best at. So plasma, and think about plasma, there's actually a couple different big variations in plasma cutting. One is an air plasma, like is used on a light industrial table like this one. This one's got a PowerMax 125 from Hypertherm on it, air plasma cutting system. Air plasma is the lowest cost to purchase and also one of the lowest costs to operate. So the cost per foot of cut, which includes the cost of the consumables, the cost of air, the cost of electricity, all those things. They're really reasonable with an air plasma cutting system. Then the second kind of type of plasma cutting is high definition plasma cutting. You're going to see that on a little bit, usually bigger machines that have a little bit better bearing ways on them, different types of drive motors, higher acceleration rates and things like that, and higher cost. High definition plasma kind of takes a step above air plasma. The cutting costs are very similar, but the edges are cleaner. They use oxygen for cutting steel as opposed to air for cutting steel. You can't do that with an air plasma. And oxygen gives a better metallurgic finish on the edge of the plate, faster cut speeds, and high definition plasma are really the fastest way to cut most materials that are used in production between thin gauge material and say 1.5 to 2 inch thick material. So high definition plasma is another good choice. Laser, everybody says, well, I think I'm going to go buy a laser to cut the artwork that I'm doing. May or may not be a good idea. You need perfect artwork with really tight tolerances, and you can afford the high price of a laser cutting system, then maybe the laser's the right thing for you. But lasers have a really high capital equipment cost. When you buy them, they cost a lot, and they do a better job than most of these other processes on thin material. In fact, this is a stainless steel piece cut with a laser out of, I'm going to guess, probably 20 gauge stainless steel. Very, very nice quality. You can't do that with a plasma. You could do it with a water jet. We'll talk about that in a minute. So laser really has its niche. It's really more of a precision sheet metal machine. Yes, there are lasers that can cut 1 inch thick steel. They're going to be a heck of a lot slower than plasma and only slightly better in tolerance. So you really have to weigh, how much am I going to pay for my machine? How much is it going to cost me to cut? And what do I need for cut part accuracy and tolerances? Sometimes a laser gets those orders, and most of the time on thicker material, the plasma gets the orders. So, and then last but not least, water jet. There's one other one, oxy fuel, we'll have to talk about as well. But water jet can cut virtually anything you put on the table. It's for somebody like me that's been cutting metal for 40 years, I just have an absolute ball playing with a water jet, but I've never cut a piece of metal on it. I keep putting stone and glass and things like that on it because I can't do that with my plasma cutter. Water jets are basically use a very high pressure, as much as 90,000 PSI stream of water that's forced through a garnet or a diamond orifice, and then garnet abrasive, kind of like sand that's used on sandpaper. is injected into that stream. And the actual garnet is what does the cutting. The water carries it at a high velocity. It's a slow process. If you're cutting 1-inch steel, you can you're going to be in the very low, maybe 1, 2, 3 inches a minute, where plasma is going to cut that same thickness at 65, 75, 85 inches a minute. So it's a much slower process, but the advantage to the water jet is there's no heat affected zone. It's got very, very tight tolerances, just one notch below what you'd get out of a machine shop off a milling machine. And so because it's so slow, the cost per foot of cut is higher than any of these other processes. But if you need the versatility to cut all the different materials, and especially when you get onto softer materials, if you want to cut rubber, if you want to cut wood, it's going to be a very fast, very productive process. Just not the best as far as productivity goes on steel. And oxy-fuel is the oldest of all these processes, been around for a long time. It only cuts steel. It will not cut stainless steel, will not cut aluminum, will not cut other materials. It uses a relatively high consumption of gas, usually propane or acetylene or something like that for a fuel gas and oxygen. And it really shines when you get above 1.5 inches, usually around 2 inch. Plasma does a good job right up to that point. And then the oxy fuel is actually a better process when you get into really thick carbon steel. Very common to see machines that have one or two or three or as many as four plasma torches. And there's one I've seen on the production floor today that has 9 oxy fuel torches on it. So 9 torches running simultaneously can make quite a few parts at the end of the day on thick material. So a lot of differences in those processes: plasma, water jet, laser, and oxy fuel. You need to choose the one that fits your needs best, be it productivity, be it cut part accuracy, and also take a look at both the operating costs and the capital equipment purchase costs. Add those up together over time, and that's your cost of ownership of those machines. Which one's the right one for you? We'd be happy to help you out with that and make sure that you get the right process for your needs. Thank you very much.